Hey guys, welcome to Healthy Start, May 23rd edition. We hope you're all doing well. We're going to get right started with this one today. Here's a video on all of our planets. Check it out. It's pretty cool.
Storybots.
We can see the whole solar system from here.
I think we can hear it from here too.
We are the planets of the solar system. Different sizes for everyone. The music never ends. We are such good friends. And we all orbit the sun.
Here comes the sun, rapping first on this track. From the beginning, I'm the center of the solar system. Planets be spinning around me. So hot, I'm roasting, you see. Now I pass a mic to the planet closest to me.
Mercury, the smallest planet, small as Earth's moon.
Yo.
I get super hot and cold, and it's been very slow.
I'm Venus, I got mountains and volcanoes that spray. I'm the same size as Earth, but spin the opposite way.
Yeah, I'm Earth, I'm the home to every boy and girl.
Such a beautiful, beautiful world.
On Mars, a red planet, I got deserts and ice. And I've got two moons, that's like one moon twice.
I'm Jupiter, the biggest planet, I'm humongous. Gargantuan, I spin the fastest, rap the fastest. Plus I'm handsome, blam son.
Oh please, I'm Saturn, check out my beautiful rings. Made up of billions of rocks, dust, and other things.
I'm Uranus, I say that with pride. Okay, I lied, I'm embarrassed. Cause I'm the only planet lying on its side.
I'm Neptune, I'm cold, dark, windy, and mysterious. I'm very stormy, so bring an umbrella, I'm serious.
We are the planets of the solar system. Different sizes for everyone. The music never ends. We are such good friends, and we all orbit the sun.
Well, we are done exploring the solar system.
I am thirsty. Let's explore the rest of the Milky Way galaxy.
That was a fun video about the planets in the solar system. Now we're on to learning our animal of the week. Can you guess the animal of the week? Let's find out.
Foxes. Foxes are small mammals with an orange coat and bushy tail. They're native to Britain, but can now be found all over the world. They're distant relatives with dogs and wolves, but live in small family groups instead of packs. And like all omnivores, they can eat almost anything. Cunning foxes are great hunters. Carefully, the fox sneaks up on its prey.
What a wonderful leap!
Foxes have amazing hearing, meaning they can listen for prey under the snow. With another great leap, the fox is able to hunt for mice deep beneath the snow. Male foxes are called dogs. Female foxes are called vixens, and baby foxes are called cubs. Foxes have comfy burrows for homes. Here's a small cub coming out of her burrow. Doesn't she have lovely black feet and a great furry coat? Do you know what noise a fox makes? Well, they can make several. They can yelp, bark, growl, and whine. Just like this. Ew. That's not a nice noise, is it? Click on the videos above to see more amazing animals. And be sure to subscribe.
I learned a lot about foxes. Did you learn a lot too? Our next activity is our craft. Have fun! Hey guys, welcome back, and I'm going to show you what our craft is this week. So you will need any kind of paper, cut them into an umbrella shape, like that. Get your mom and dad or your older siblings or someone to help you with scissors. You'll need another piece of paper, any color you like, for the handle of our umbrella. You just take that and cut out your handle for your umbrella so it looks like this. You're going to need a pencil to draw out your umbrella shape. You're going to need a pair of scissors to help cut out. You'll also need a glue stick, any kind of blue paint. Now, parents, use your discretion. It could be watercolor based or acrylic. I'm using acrylic here because this is what I have. You're going to need some bubble wrap. Doesn't matter if it's popped, can be unpopped or popped. We are going to be using this as a pattern today. You're going to need a plate or some sort of container for your paint. You will need a paintbrush and you will need a plain piece of paper. All right, guys, join me back and I'll show you how to make our craft. Hey guys, welcome back. And I'm here with the lovely Tage. He's going to make our craft with us. So Tage, what's the first thing we have to do?
First thing is we need to make the umbrella out of these.
Okay, put it on the paper and show them.
This is what the umbrella is going to look like when it's finished.
So we're going to glue that into place right now?
Yep.
And what part of the umbrella should we glue first?
I'm going to re-glue this part.
That's right, the handle. So go ahead, throw some glue on that handle.
Yeah, because if you glue that part, you won't know where you glue.
That's right.
I just put it everywhere.
Yeah.
Okay, it might get a bit messy, but here's the glue.
All right. Well, I'd like for that to... There you go.
Then we stick it onto here.
So we've got a little umbrella.
Yep. And now here's the fun part. We need to glue it on. Tell us how we glue it on in the comments down below.
So now we're going to put some glue. If I glue it, will you stick it on there? Alrighty. It's been raining a lot today. This whole week in Elkford. Spring has definitely arrived. Here, you take that and put it down. Excellent. Now comes the fun part.
Yeah.
Now we paint with bubble wrap. You're going to take your paint, any paint you have, shake it up. And here we go. Oh, I think we've got a cloth. Look at that glue. Nice blue shade. So we're going to put paint on our bubble wrap. We're going to take our bubble wrap. We're just going to take a small section about the size of our hand. And we're going to just paint all over
it.
Oh, of course. Here you are.
You need more paint because it's running out already. You always need lots of paint when you're painting bubble wrap. Or you run out.
I didn't know you were such an expert on painting bubble wrap.
Yeah, you go very careful. Take this, move like this, make sure you get the insides of it.
Yeah, you want lots of paint on there.
Yeah, like this. This is what it's going to look like when it's finished, except all around. We're gonna speed up the video a bit.
Oh no, we can't because Mom doesn't know how to do that. Anyway, can I have a turn, please?
Yeah, but we're gonna pause the video so we can do this.
No, we're gonna show them right now.
Yeah.
So we got lots and lots of paint on a good section of our bubble wrap. So what we're going to do is we're going to turn it upside down so the wet side of the paint is facing outward, and we're going to start pushing with our hands.
Yeah, I'm going to push.
Yeah, push, Tage.
Like this. And push like this.
Alrighty.
All the way like this, and when you take the bubble wrap,
peel it off and see. We've got rain. Lots of rain. So you can take the same piece and... Do you want to do the other side?
Yes.
Here. There you go, Tage.
Do I get the paint?
No, you get to push that on Push it down. There we go. Let's carefully lift it and see. Oh, we're going to need some more. All right. Put some more paint on, please.
On this side?
No, just in the same spot. That way we can reuse the bubble wrap again and again. There you go.
What? We might have to pause the video. We'll end the video now.
All right, Sage, can I have a turn, please?
Yes, just
thank you.
Do a little bit more.
Yes, I know. We got to work together as a team.
Yeah. Okay, so Mom, that should be enough.
Here, you finish spreading it around, and we'll make some more rain for our craft.
Yeah, but remember, we need to make rain clouds. That's important or no? We need rain clouds.
All right, I think this looks ready.
Yep. That's the paintbrush. Let's get to work. Oh, yeah, do you like my new shirt? Yeah, I'm a creeper on it.
You are a creeper. There we go.
Whoa, but I was thinking about putting it some right here.
Oh, yeah. Here, let's take it. All right, push up on it. And what is the main purpose of an umbrella, Tage?
It can make it all the way and go to the side of it. Like this. Oh, we need more paint.
We do. We need a thin strip of paint.
Let me.
All right. We would love to see the different ones that you guys have made. Please post a picture of your craft in the comment section below. We love seeing our local artists flourish here in town. There's a lot of talent, isn't there, bud?
Yeah, there is. And I'm a talent at painting.
All right. I think that's enough.
No, let's give this up. You can have a turn.
Oh, it's okay. We're just going to keep reusing it. That's the nice part about it. Put some here. Remember, the umbrella's main goal is to keep the rain.
Oh.
Yeah, you do this one, Tage. The umbrella's main goal is to keep the rain off of you. Oh, let's take a look and lift it up. Tage, can you show them?
This is what it's going to look like when you're finished.
Look at that. Well, everybody, I hope you had fun doing the craft.
Yep. See you later. Bye.
Hey, guys, I hope you enjoyed. Our next activity is our snack, and it's pretty fun, so come check it out. I'd love to see what kind of creations you guys have made with your families. Post a picture below in the comment section.
Hi, I'm Kira from MyFussyEater.com. If you have trouble getting your kids to eat veggies, then stay tuned because I have a really fun and simple snack for you to try today. I hope you enjoyed this really fun snack for kids. If you did, please do give it a thumbs up. Also, let me know in the comment section below what kind of ways you get your kids to eat veggies, And also, don't forget to subscribe for lots more recipes. See you next time. Bye.
All right, welcome back. And our final part of Healthy Start is our story. And this is, by golly, my favorite story at all. It's by Robert Munsch, and it's called Purple, Green, and Yellow. So you guys all have a great week and enjoy the story by Robert Munsch, Purple, Green, and Yellow.
There was this girl named Bridget, and one day she went to her mom and says, "Mom, my friends, they have these wonderful markers, Mom. They color with these markers. It's just wonderful. I need some coloring markers." And the mom says, "Now, Bridget, I've heard about these markers. Your friends draw on the floor. They draw on the wall. They draw on themselves. Bridget, you can't have any markers." "Wait," says Bridget, "Mom, there are markers that wash off. I can't get in any trouble if they wash off, Mom." "Good idea," says the mom. The mom went out and bought Bridget 500 markers that washed off. Bridget went upstairs. She drew wonderful pictures. She drew sunshine and oranges and apples and lemons. But after a week, she came back down. She says, "Mom, did I draw on the floor?" Mom says, "No." "Did I draw on the wall?" Mom says, "No." "Did I draw on myself?" Mom says, "No." "Well," says Bridget, "there are these other wonderful markers, Mom. They have markers that smell. It's so wonderful, Mom. They have markers that smell. They smell like roses and lemons and apples and cowplops." So Bridget goes and says, "Mom, they smell like anything you want, Mom. I need those markers." Mom went and she bought Bridget these wonderful markers. Bridget went upstairs and she drew roses that smelled like roses, lemons that smells like lemons, oranges that smells like oranges, and cowplops that smelled like cowplops. She went down and she says, "Mom, did I draw on myself?" Mom says, "No." "Did I draw on the wall?" Mom says, "No." "Did I draw on the floor?" Mom says, "No." "Well," says Bridget, "these really good markers, all my friends have them. They're called super incredible, never come off till you're dead, and maybe even later, magic markers. And Mom, I need those markers." So the mom went out and she bought Bridget 500 super incredible, never come off till you're dead, and maybe even later, coloring markers. And Bridget went upstairs. She drew wonderful pictures. She drew lemons that look better than lemons, roses that look better than roses, rainbows that look better than rainbows. And then she got bored. She said, but, you know, even my mother colors her fingernails, so it's okay to color your fingernails." And she colored her fingernails purple, green, and yellow. And that was so nice, she colored her hands yellow, green, and pink. And that was so nice, she colored her face orange, blue, and red. And that was so nice, she colored her belly button green. And that was so nice, she colored herself almost entirely all over. And then she looked in the mirror and went, "Ah! My mom's gonna kill me! Ah!" She ran to the bathroom, washed her hands, nothing came off. She said, "Oh, I'm in trouble now. What am I gonna..." She got an idea. She went to the box of markers, got a marker that was her same regular original color. She colored herself entirely all over. When she was done, she looked just like before, even better than before. She went downstairs. The mom says, "Hey, Bridget, you're looking really good today." "Yes, sir. You've been getting a lot of sun." "Yes," said Bridget, "I'm feeling really good. Yeah, definitely. I'm looking really good. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir." The mom says, "Well, Bridget, it's time to wash your hands for dinner." Bridget was afraid that the people color would come off and the mom would see that her hands looked like rainbows with mental problems. She said, "Mo, no, mom, I'm all clean." The mom smelled her hands and said, "Ah, no soap." She went over, washed Bridget's hands. All the color came off. The underneath color looked like rainbows with mental problems. The mom says, "Bridget, did you color yourself with the markers that wash off?" Bridget said, "No, not the ones that smelled." She said, "No, please, Bridget, not the super incredible ones that never come off to your dead, maybe later magic markers. Tell me you didn't use those." Bridget said, "Yes, I used them." The mom goes, "Oh, no." She called the doctor. "You got to help me. Bridget colored herself with the super incredible never come off to your dead, maybe even later coloring markers." "Oh, dear," says the doctor. "Sometimes they never come off."
doctor came over with a purple pill and said, have your kid take this pill. See if it works. Bridget took the pill, ran, jumped in the bathtub. She's going, Mom says, Bridget, is the color coming off? Yes, says Bridget, it's all gone. Oh, good, says the mother. And it was all gone because Bridget walked out the door. She was invisible. You couldn't see her at all. And Mom says, Bridget, you can't go to school if you're invisible. You won't get a job if you're invisible, Bridget. Don't worry, says Bridget. She ran, got that marker the same color as herself. She colored herself entirely all over. When she was done, she looked even better than before. Mom says, Bridget, you're just a picture. Everybody will know there's something wrong. Not something wrong, said Bridget. Nobody will know it. She took the mom in, showed the dad, and said, see, I colored Daddy when he was taking a nap, and you never even noticed, and he'll be all right, unless he goes out in the rain.